Hello all of my YouTube channel and the TikTok families. This is to express about the child Heaven that was killed by one rapist in Ethiopia. Now concerning on this, there are a number of activists or humanitarian persons are just debating the decision given by Amara Regional State Bahrdar High Court. In case of this, the criminal or the rapist has committed very, very aggravated crimes on this 7 years child. Her age is 7 and she is just unable to withstand what the rapist has done on her, so that she has just died because of he has filled her mouth with the sand, and she has been died, and the case has been, I think it has been about 6 or 7 months. After 7 months later, things has been just the her mother just accused of that the decision given by for rapist is it is very, very few, because of the court has decided 25 years fine punishment, 25 years of punishment. But she has just accused about the decision passed over him. And concerning on this, a number of TikTokers, YouTubers, and other social media platform users just raise the issue, and the issue has now become the national issue, even greater than national, and it has become international issue. Those who cannot understand what we have seen in was said in American language, let me tell you a pieces of information about this, and then let me tell you the legal ground that they have used how to save the rapist, the judges, and even the other parties that are besides that unseen forces or unseen persons has played a significant role in order to decide this weak decision through judges. In principle, I know that judges in Ethiopian context or in Ethiopian constitution, judges have the full right to decide whatever they want. According to the federal constitution, our constitution proclaims about the judge. Judges are including the judicial powers, including judges are free from any interference. According to Article 79, sub Article 2, courts of any level shall be free from any interference of influence of any governmental body, governmental official, or from any other source. Judges shall exercise their functions in full independence and shall be directed solely by the law. They are just solely directed by or led by the law. What they refer is law, but not other external influences. But as we have seen, there are, I think, external influences that shows that why that this punishment has not been passed through this rapist. Now let us see what our criminal code, the Ethiopian criminal code, says about such aggravated crimes. Let us see. And under sub-article 1, C says that, the title says that, aggravated homicide, and whosoever intentionally commits homicide to further another crime or to conceal a crime already committed is punishable with rigorous imprisonment for life or death. There are two options. Aggravated homicide. This is aggravated homicide. And there is no such any other aggravated homicide that has been or occurred except in this child. We haven't seen. I know why the judges haven't given the decisions over or the this penalty over this rapist. They want to benefit the rapists because of they have used only one circumstance that he shall prevent himself or defend himself. That is, he is the family administrator, and in addition to this, he hasn't been participated any crime before this. In order to save him, they used the Article 620. Normally, Article 620 talks about rape, the crime of rape. Under this article, it says that in the 620 sub-article 3, it says that where the rape has caused grave physical or mental injury or this, the punishment shall be life imprisonment. So that they have used this article in order to save this criminal, this dangerous criminal. There is no other dangerous criminal such except from such has been committed by these children. It is immoral when we think about why how he has done, how the rapist has done, is it is very, very, very immoral thing, because she is under 10 years under age and 7 years old. And on another case, he has raped. I'm sorry in order to explain this. The such matter, it is a dangerous one. Therefore, we never accept the decision that has been passed by the Bahar Dar High Court. Therefore, even what surprising fact is, even he has asked appeal. Because of he said that I haven't committed such crime, and I have just offered the delineating factors that are I'm family administrator and other things. It is not acceptable, because of there is no mercy. Then he has to be this penalty shall be passed over this one. Unless and the other one, other crimes, such crimes are, or irrelevant crimes are, increasing through the time in order to protect other children from such kinds of event. The court has to take a revise. There are grounds of revision of the decisions given by in principle court. For example, if someone has not accepted the first instance court, he shall appeal to the high court. If the high court, then the supreme court, and even up to appellate court. Then after, if the appellate court has not given right decision, then he has to go to up to House of Federation. Therefore, however, this penalty must be passed over this dangerous criminal, because of we have I understand that Ethiopia has signed some international agreements. They are just part of our constitution. However, we have to stop this kind of event has to be stopped here, because of the generation is under hard condition. In order to save the generation from such dangerous crimes, the court has to revise the decision. And the decision given by the Bahar Dar High Court is really, really, it is not correct. They have to use Article 539 again. But the optionally they have used the Article 620 sub Article 3 in order to save this. It is not correct.